Hey everyone, and happy Saturday. This is a series that I do, and it's called Post-Week Peaks, Pits, and Plateaus. So the peaks are the things that I loved this week. The pits are things that I gave a thumbs down to, and the plateaus are the things that were just kind of okay, but within my radar, used and looked at or consumed every day. And there's not a whole lot in here. It's just a little pink basket. And it's a mix of home fragrance and just some beauty products and even some vitamins that I got from a dermstore beauty fix. So let me start with those. These are the Hum Gummies with Benefits. These are the Skin Hydration for the Ultimate Glow, Glow Sweet Glow. And there are 16 tangerine vegan gummies. And these are just so-so. So it has hyaluronic acid, vitamin C, and E. That noise is my cat using his cat scratcher, like a good boy. I've been putting lots of hyaluronic acid on my skin the past, 3 to 4 months, and it's starting to feel like spring here in the Midwest. But I usually take these two at a time, which is what is recommended. And it's just kind of a plateau for me. I like the taste, and because of the taste, the tangerine, it kind of makes me want to take it. If it tastes terrible, I probably would have tossed it or passed it along to a friend, but I am a vegan for the most part. I do consume cheese now and then, but for the most part, meatless, plant-based diet, so I really liked that. Even though this came in kind of a surprise subscription box, it was vegan. So I do recommend these Hum Nutrition gummies if you like the orange, tangerine, citrusy flavors. And then one of my peaks of the week, one of my favorite items, is this fragrance spray from Scentsy, and it's Go Go Mango. I got this in a whiff box, which is Scentsy's version of like a surprise box, like what you would get from FabFitFun or BoxyCharm or something like that. But it is my favorite box to get every month, and this was included. This one is kind of a large mist. I don't know how well the camera's gonna pick it up, but I like to do kind of a lighter scent like this, like on a Saturday like today or on the weekend, because I'm doing different things like cooking and then running errands and then being out in the yard with the kids or going hiking. That kind of thing. And I don't want the heavier perfume that I tend to put on really early in the morning before I head to the office. So it's not a super long lasting scent, but I like the bottle's design. It's very thin and I can slide it into both my crossbody bags and my larger kind of shoulder bags that I like to switch back and forth from. And then another Scentsy product that has been definitely a peak of the week is Bonfire Beach. And this one just came back February 1st. It was very popular in the spring and summer catalog last year. I believe it was its first year. And then it was gone for the fall and winter. And I did not stock up on it. It was so good that I thought they would keep it. But Scentsy doesn't play that way. But I'm so happy it's back. And I want to get several bars for myself. I've been melting it here in my open concept area. It's got like a woodsy kind of bonfire toasted marshmallowy scent, but it's kind of fresh at the same time. And I don't have anyone in my family that doesn't like it, which is a huge bonus with a large family like mine. But again, it's Bonfire Beach, two thumbs up. Love it. I don't think I'm going to get tired of this. I'm going to stock up on it just in case they take it out of the catalog again in the fall, but we got a long way to go till the next catalog. So if you're looking for something that's different that you're probably going to really enjoy, it's Bonfire Beach. Hi, Scout. And then another just kind of plateau are these L'Oreal Revitalift Bright Reveal Pads. I have purchased two or three of these from CVS, and they have them at Walmart and Walgreens and Target. And they are these thin exfoliating pads, very affordable. I believe they're $20 or less, and you frequently can get a coupon for those in the Sunday paper or in your email or from the CVS Extra Care. Super long receipt that prints out at the end of the day. And I believe that there are 30 pre-soaked pads in each package. So it's funny that I say it's a Plateau because I keep buying it. I do prefer the Dr. Dennis Gross Alpha Beta Peel, but they cost literally four times as much. So if you're looking for an affordable alternative, these L'Oreal Revitalift Bright Reveal pads are easily accessible and affordable. And then another Plateau that I have is this Pond's Cold Cream Cleansing Balm. And I started using this toward the end of February, and you may have seen it last weekend in my March skincare video. I'm about halfway through it. It is a thicker consistency than what I'm used to in a cleansing balm, but it does a wonderful job just melting off the eyeliner and mascara. I believe that it's leaking a little bit because I grabbed it out of my shower. I believe that it was $10 and I had a coupon for it, so I think I ended up paying $8. My definite peak is the Vanilla Co. Clean at Zero, and I have seen that recently at my CVS. It's usually $17 or $18, and you can get it on Amazon. I believe it's at Ulta. But this, if you haven't tried a cleansing balm, this is a perfect one to get started with. You're not gonna hate it. And then another peak of the week is this single wick candle from Bath & Body Works. It's Fiji White Sands. And I got this when they were on sale for like $6. It is described as fresh cut sugarcane, white nectarine, and sandalwood. And it says these little single wicks will burn for 25 to 45 hours. I don't ever purchase these unless they're around the $6, $7 mark, and then I usually have a 20% coupon. But I've been really impressed with them lately. There were a couple years where I never bought these. I just couldn't smell them. They're awkward and too small to put in my candle crock, which you can see the beige candle crock behind me. It's just too awkward. And I'm really liking just kind of the different designs the Bath & Body Works is coming up with this spring. So about halfway done with this one and really enjoying Fiji White Sands. And two makeup items. My Plateau here is my CoverGirl Clean Normal Skin Foundation. This was probably $5. I'm the shade 105 Ivory. And my skin does tend to get a little bit darker as we're heading into the summer. But I noticed there's like a little bit of a grainy texture with this, and it's irritating my skin just a little bit. But the color is really good, and it's really long lasting for being a drugstore foundation. So, but there's just something grainy about it that I didn't notice when I first had this out. I had put it away for a little while, maybe 6 months or so. But I am using tretinoin on my skin, as you saw in my March skincare video last weekend. And just don't want anything that's gonna be kind of grainy. So comment below if you've tried this and had that experience. It's not enough that's gonna make me stop using it. I'm about halfway through the bottle right now. And it literally was probably $5 or $6. And it's a really good color for me. I honestly don't know the different range of colors, if they're any good for lots of different skin types. I know it must be extremely frustrating for those of you that can't ever find your skin type. I'm usually like second to the palest. So I am lucky in that respect, but the price point on these are really, really good if you can find your color. Last item is a peek, and I had put this away for a while. I bought this around the time I got married in October of 2018, and this is the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I don't know how well it's showing up on camera, but there are different pictures of places all over the world. There's Big Ben, and there's some islands, Ferris wheels, let's see, there's Vegas up here, and just someone with a road map. There is the Golden Gate Bridge. But the inside is really the best part of the palette. The shades are a mix of shimmer and matte. And as you can see, I'm kind of liking the darker colors in this palette, especially that purple color. I believe it's called Guilt Trip. I have been putting that, kind of using it as an eyeliner on work days. It's a little too heavy to wear on like a Saturday, but I've been putting it kind of right very thinly next to my lash line, and I really like just that dark hint of purple sometimes, especially if I'm wearing a jewel toned outfit. I think it really makes it pop. And then I do have, as you've seen, my dark kind of purple square glasses. I like the way that looks as well. There's a little bit of fallout with this palette, so just be aware of that. I know it's still available, and I think I saw it, I think it's still at Ulta, but it's got a really, let's put my finger here in Baja. It's really pigmented, and it lasts all day. That's Baja. And even though there's some fallout with it, I'm always really diligent about tapping it on my faucet. My husband probably just thinks I'm doing art projects in the morning before he gets up with all the eyeshadow fallout. But once you get it on and you use a setting spray, the NYX setting spray is awesome. The MAC Prep and Prime, you're gonna be really happy with this palette. It's got a lot of staying power. And like I said, it's matte and shimmer. It goes from extremely light to even a black called Jet. So lots of fun colors. And this is the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. 2 thumbs up. So hope you enjoy the rest of your Saturday and the rest of your weekend. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.